Hey coach, thanks so much for watching this week's video. Wanted to show you something I'm really excited about. It's brand new. Go to Flag Football with Coach D. Make sure you subscribe so you get 10% off everything anytime. But down here, we just released our brand new wristbands. So now I've got a plug and play bundle, which includes all of my playbooks, all of my practices, all of my drills, over 80 age-based plays. I mean, it's just awesome. This is the most popular thing that I offer. And now we have wristbands, Coach D wristbands plug and play system. So you can take plays, take it to the field, walk out there with confidence and watch your players just execute at the highest level. All right, let's jump into this week's video.
Hi everyone, this is Coach D and...
This is Noah, my Coach D's son.
Okay, all right. You guys have seen Noah over the years. He's been playing since he was 5 and now at almost 13, he is ready to show us some rushing. What are we talking about today?
Today we're just talking about rushing.
Okay.
And how to like if they're like in the front, like just like if they're trying to fake handoff, mm-hmm. you just want to try to get in there and just keep your eye on the ball.
Okay, yeah, we'll talk about principles. Why are you here?
I'm here because I'm really good at rushing and I've been rushing for about 3 seasons.
Yeah. Yeah, he's been rushing. So in our league, at 4th grade, you're able to start rushing. And we've just found that Noah has an ability with his speed, with the things you're going to learn today to get to that quarterback or to quickly disrupt if they have fakes or if they hand off. He's able to quickly get into the backfield, disrupt their offense immediately. He's probably one of the best at it. So that's what we're going to go into today. What we've done is we've set out, Noah, our defense out here. How many yards off the line of scrimmage does
seven
it
yards.
Okay, so 7 yards off the line of scrimmage. Are you allowed to have 2 people rushing, or is it only one? Or
It can be up to 2.
Yeah, you can do 2. You could rush the whole entire team from the 7-yard line if you want to. We found that it's usually best for 1, sometimes 2. If you find that you can easily cover the field and you can disrupt that quarterback quickly with 2 of your speedsters, you can easily do that. But today we're just going to focus on having 1 rusher. And what we've laid out here is the famous Husker defense, Noah. So you have a linebacker here on our first cone. Then you have 3 cornerbacks, 1, 2, 3, out here on that 7 yards. And then we have a safety, or what you call a...
I call a monster.
Yeah, Noah, when he was younger, would always be in the back, and we'd have him be the monster. So you have the monster in the back. That's called the safety, has the entire field. Now, we have some other videos that talk about the defense, strategy, and formations, and all that good stuff. But today, let's just talk about rushing. So what we've done, Noah, this season is we're going to count that off as 2, 3, and 4. So that cone over there is position 2. The middle cone is position 3. And the cone over here on this side is position 4. And what we're gonna do to mix it up, especially at this age, 6th, 7th, and 8th, we're gonna actually mix up who's gonna be rushing. Now, because it's 7 yards off of the line of scrimmage, Noah, any of those 2, 3, or 4 can rush. Now, last season what we did is we just had Noah rushing almost every single time from that one spot. Is that right?
I switched like I switched like 3 times every quarter.
Okay.
I mean every like halftime.
Okay. But it wasn't like all the time. It wasn't switching on and off. Okay. What we want to do is we want to really disrupt that offense and keep them guessing, not knowing who's going to rush. So, we have 2, 3, 4 and we're going to call out who's going to be rushing, right, in kind of some secret tone, and we'll teach you about that. But let's give some quick principles. Let's say you're over here. Go to that cone over there. Yep. So now Noah is lined up in position 2, right? So you'll have, again, depending on if you're 5v5, 6v6, 7v7, you can mix this up. Maybe have 2 here, you know, 2 in the back, etc. But this Husker works no matter what you're at, 5, 6, 7, it doesn't matter. So he's in position 2. And what he is going to be doing, and most leagues have the rule that he has to have a direct line to the quarterback. So there's no blocking. You know, if I have a center here, a center can't move into position, right? So what are a couple principles? What are you looking for when you're coming this direction? What are you looking at primarily?
The ball.
You're looking at the ball. Why?
Because, like, you want to see who has it at what point of time.
Okay. What could happen? What could the quarterback easily do?
Fake.
Okay. So they could fake, right? So he's coming in, and if they fake, right, that could easily, right, pull him in that direction if he's not watching, right? If he's watching a running back, if he's watching whoever's in the backfield, or even if he's watching the quarterback, right? So what he does is he keeps his eye on the ball. All right. What else? When you come in, a lot of rushers come full speed, but what Noah does is different. He's coming full speed, but then show us what you do half speed right about here.
So full speed there and then.
Half speed all the way up.
I look forward.
You're looking forward? Hold on right there. That's good. Why are you looking forward?
So then they don't know who's rushing.
They don't know who's rushing. So show me if you are giving away that you're going to rush. Look at that. You could just see it, right? Now show me no one's going to know. And what we've done now is that 3, 4, or 2 could be rushing. So all of them are going to be just looking straight ahead as if they're going into coverage. Awesome. So then right away, go half speed. He's coming in. Now what do you do right here?
I break down.
That's it right there. That's some secret sauce right there, just like pulling from the handle. That is what's made him so effective. Why do you break down right here instead of just coming full speed the whole entire time?
Because sometimes if I go full speed, then I will, like, they fake, and then I'll just run right past.
You're going to run right past them, and then what happens?
They can throw, they have time.
Then the quarterback can easily move out of the way. They can go one way or the other, right? So what Noah does is he comes in, let's say I'm the quarterback, I've just fake handed off. He could go that direction if I do hand off and quickly grab the flag over there. See that hand over there? Or he can stick with me and grab my flag right here. Boom, he's ready to go. Now, even if the quarterback makes a move, let's say fake and makes a move, he can still, right now, at this point, he's in a good position to stay with me. No matter what I'm doing, he can now, do the stuff that we've talked about for so long, where he's now squaring up, even if I'm running this way, right? Now, Noah, check this out. I'm going to teach you maybe a little something different. Let's say my strong side, meaning I feel comfortable. If I run this way, I can throw it. But if you get me going this way, then I can't really be accurate. This is called my weak side as a quarterback, and this is called my strong side over here. So if you pull me this way, then I could probably get away from you and throw the ball. So what would you want to do as you came up here?
I'd probably want to go like
this. Check
this
out. Oh, look at what he's doing. You see what he just did? You see the switch? What he just did is magic. What did you just do? This is magic.
I went like...
This is coaching in the moment right here. And what did you do? Yep. What is he blocking off?
Your good side.
Boom! They get it. They get it just like that. He has never heard that. We've not talked about it. It wasn't a prep for this video. Why do you want to block off my strong side?
So you can't, so you're not as good, and you could most likely maybe throw a interception.
Boom, that's it. That's that money right there. If I can teach you or Noah anything else, it is no matter what, you're gonna find really quick, probably in the first couple plays, which side that strong side is for that quarterback. And you wanna block that off. So when you're coming in, so let's say you're coming in from number 3, let's say we call out whatever we call out, and he knows that, okay, number 3 is going to be rushing in. Come in on that. And you can go full speed now. Now that he knows, my strong side is this way. Ready, go. You want to come this way. So here's what you want to do. You want to power even if I'm gonna, if I'm coming in and this center has to get out of the way to give a straight line, you want to kind of come in on this side. Yep. Even if I'm gonna hand off this way, just in case, you want to come in and block off that side, right? So yeah, and you want to almost, so imagine you're quarterback.
Ready, go.
I want to block off. I want to block off this side, because if you're going to try to run, I want you to run that way. Yep. But what Noah just told us, all right, so we got a couple good principles. When you're first coming in, what are you looking for?
The football.
Cool. Why do you want to do that?
So then you can't get tricked.
Tricked, right. No matter what they're going to do, if they're doing a fake handoff, he's not going to get tricked by that. He's, right? What's another secret when you're running in?
I break down.
Huge. You'll see it. So many of our rushers, they will literally run right past, try to catch it, and gone. But Noah, what he does, why don't you run full speed to this point and show us how you break down. Ready, go. Yep. And at that point, he's either going to go for that handoff, if the handoff is happening, whichever way, or he's going to do what?
Break down.
You're going to break down, but now what are you also going to be doing?
Shuffle and go to his bad side.
That's right.
That's right.
You are going to shut down his good side. So as you come up, there's a lot of things that are happening. No matter what position, let's try this position. Let's say my good side is this way. Ready, go. Yep, you want to get over there. Yep. So you want to take that angle so that you're shutting down. When you break down a little bit over here. Cheat a little bit to this side. Now, if they hand off, you can quickly maneuver, but you can shut this down so it doesn't get around you.
Could you also, couldn't you also just, like, be in front of them?
Yeah.
And then, like, if they're faking, then you can just go, like, if one gets the ball, just go like this.
Yep.
Or like this.
You could. The goal is to break down right when you get here, not to just... Right? And then you can assess, meaning you can figure out, all right, which way, knowing that if he gets around you or she gets around you, let's say you break down right there, I could easily just go to my quick side. But if you cheated, meaning if you landed here, that's going to be a lot harder, right, for me to get out there. So that's the only reason if I'm trying to cut off one side or another, I might come over. And even if I just put my foot a little bit further on that side, if I need to grab the handoff, or I can quickly break it and stop that side. Yep. So if I'm going that way, yes, that's it. So a lot of things are happening inside the brain here of your three rushers. All right. Now, Noah is usually the one who rushes all day long. So they're going to think, okay, where is he? Where is he on the field? And then all of a sudden somebody else does. So that's what you're doing. Let's say I hand it off and I'm the running back. I'm going to take a running back going outside this way. Ready, go. I get it. Boom. So what he did right there, what'd you do?
So I watched the ball the whole time.
Yep.
Like I looked with the corner of my eye.
Corner of his eye?
And okay. Then I saw the ball go into the hand so I could just easily.
Okay. So you were able to, and because he's thinking break down instead of just run right past, run through, right? He's thinking, okay, if I need to stop right here and grab that, that's something that could happen. So he's aware of that. Now let's do it the other side. Let's say you're at this position again and I take the
that way.
And I go that way. Let's just try it. Ready, go. Yep. Yeah, look, it's crazy. A good rusher like that can pick that up so fast and it just disrupts the offense every time. How's it feel?
Good.
Feels pretty good.
I like rushing.
Yeah, they usually do. And then when you start switching it up, they're like, dude, just let me rush every time. Which is all good. I get it. So we'll see how this season goes, but I think you all have a nice kind of preview of what your rushing can look like. Play around with it. Different positions, obviously, on the field. In our league, it has to be 7 yards. Anything else?
No.
All right, man. That's it. This guy's been crushing it out here for years. Good job. Shh-cow. All right, this is Coach D and...
Noah Braswell
in the house. If you like what you see, go ahead and subscribe, comment.
Hit the bell.
I don't know. Something like that. Share. Do something. Yeah. Now, if you need any of those, you know, all the stuff that we do, we have the complete coach package. That gives you practices, schedules. That gives you templates. It gives you plays. It gives you all of this stuff. We also are now offering our wristbands. So you can get all of this. Plus, you can customize the plays. Yeah, you can customize everything in the play builder as well. So come on, get some this season. We'll see you in the next video.
Have a good day.
Have a good day. Take care.